just checked off. We need to go talk to Lafayette so we can continue the story. Right now I'm by myself. Everybody else is just lollygagging around. And you'll see at the bottom of the map that we have an EX monster destroy. Yeah, after we're done here, I'm going after him next. Floric boots. Alright, Lafayette. Let's see what you're up to, buddy.
Hey, don't overwork yourself.
I'm sorry.
Why are you apologizing?
Isn't it obvious? I disobeyed you, Velvet.
Don't sweat it. I'm still alive, thanks to you.
I didn't want to see you die. That's why I did that. To save you.
I'm sorry too. Acting the way I did. Treating you like an object.
When I came with you, that was my own choice. You gave me the freedom to choose.
And what would you choose now? We only have more troubles ahead.
You're still going to fight, aren't you?
Yeah, I can't stop now.
Even so, I've made my choice. I'm coming with you.
I see.
Anyway, it's not like I have any idea where we are now.
That's a good point.
Ah-ha-ha! But an object misused is one thing. A person misused is quite another.
What's your point?
What's your point, is what I want to know. Not only did you blow the whole revenge thing, you didn't even leave a scratch. Do you have any plan on where to go from here?
I'll admit it. Unominot's power is far beyond what I could ever have imagined. But I'll never give up. No matter how many times I have to try, I'll devour them all.
Bet you 100 gold you break first.
Huh?
You heard me. 100 gold says that you give up. I lost a bet with Rokuro when you had to go and survive! Cost me 10 gold! I'm just looking to come out on top.
Whatever. Fine.
Oh, then it looks like we have a bet. There might be some fun in me sticking around after all. Not that I much care how it all turns out. I'm just looking to kill time.
Hey, Velvet. I've got something that might help with Innominot.
Oh. Is this that book you took from the villa?
It is. Look closely at the crest on the cover.
It's the same one from the temple. Does that book say anything about Innominot?
Yes. But I can't read it. It's written in the ancient tongue.
Oh, don't cry, baby boy. My friend Grimoire might be able to decipher that for you.
Really?
Well, maybe, maybe not. She'd have to take a look first.
Well, where is she? Your friend, I mean.
No idea. The last letter I got from her was sent from Isolt down in Southgand.
Not much to work with here.
True, but I'll have fun watching you try.
Oh, I'll find her. Don't you worry about that.
That's the spirit. Don't give up just yet.
I'll return to the ruins and rest. All right. Because I was just a...
We'll rest inside these ruins. You're still weak.
I was just about to go. I'm like, all right, EX monster time. Like, I was getting ready to go murder that thing until I looked at the party. Yeah, like, it's just me and Lafayette right now. All right, Rokuro, what you got for me? Oh, you're back. We should get some rest soon. Alright. Yoink.
Over me? How could I have let this happen? I'm such a disgrace. To atone for this grave sin. I can do. Forgive me, Lord Artorias.
So they were awake the whole time. Get finessed.
Art.
I send Melchior to check out the Earth Points, and what a strange sight does he find.
My lord, I have failed you.
Lift your head, Eleanor. The Shepherd has a special mission for you.
A special mission?
You are to protect the Malak Lafiset and bring him to the Logris Abbey headquarters. This mission is highly classified. Not to be shared with even the legates.
Protect the Malak and bring him to the capital, then?
With the utmost secrecy. Your becoming his vessel is in fact quite fortunate.
Maybe so. But with me as his vessel, the Malak may interfere.
This Malak may have his own will, but he can be manipulated. Do whatever it takes to get the job done, Eleanor. You act under my full authorization.
Even were it to mean obeying the orders of a demon? But, my lord, what Malak could possibly be that valuable?
Are you saying you cannot?
Shame is only a fleeting emotion. It is will and reason that ultimately prevail in the face of calamity. My lord, I live to serve the principles of your teachings.
The Earth Cults will soon close. From here on, you must use your own discretion to execute your mission.
Anything like that again. Pain is scary, right?
I'm alright. No more running away.
I'm Lafiset. It's good to finally meet you properly, Eleanor.
Yeah, likewise.
Don't worry. If you try running, you won't get far. Once I've eaten your arms and legs, I merely need you alive to act as his vessel. Nothing more.
That won't be necessary. I swore an oath before our duel. An oath grants power in exchange for a certain constraint. Mine was, if
I lose, I will obey my opponent. Once put in motion, an oath cannot be broken by the one who swore it. I will keep my promise to you because I must.
An oath, is it? In that case, I have a question for you. What does the Abbey plan to do with Inominat?
To wipe out the demons, of course. We want to end the era of disaster once and for all.
And how exactly does the Abbey plan on wiping out the demons? Is Inominat going to wander the land, slaughtering them all?
They never told me. Inominat's ritual is kept confidential, even within the Abbey. All I know is that it involves Melchior.
It looks like the only way we'll figure out Inominat's true nature is by deciphering Lafayette's book. We'll have to track down Magio's friend, the one who can read the ancient tongue.
If we go to Iselt in Southgand, we ought to find some clues to her whereabouts.
But first, we have to figure out where we are now. We need to find a settler or a village. Something.
I'm surprised us chuckleheads even know our own names.
Even the greatest scholars don't know everything at first. You can't get answers without asking for them.
Fair enough. Hard to argue with that.
I've never seen a Malak quite like him.
Eleanor, your job is going to be to protect Lafayette, even if it brings you into conflict with other exorcists. Because if you turn on me...
I know. Like I said, I can't betray you.
Listen, Lafayette. If she makes any strange moves, we want you to stop her immediately, okay?
I don't think Eleanor is such a bad person. Besides, she's oath-bound to her promise.
She's lying, obviously. That's only something you do if your life depends on it.
Yep. An oath is an art that takes complex rituals and lots of hard work and time. Hardly worth the trouble, to be honest.
I told you already. She wants to take you away from us. Women are creatures of deceit, boy.
If you say so.
She's right. Of course that goes doubly so for Velvet the Vengeful Villainess.
Well, I won't deny it.
Alright. EX Monster Time. Oh, shit.
What is it, Lafayette?
I was told that women's looks can be deceiving, but I'm not sure what I'm supposed to see.
Oh.
That's an age-old problem for men. You with me, Aizen?
Aye. Women are fickle creatures at best. They lie as easily as they breathe, and men can never see through their deceptions.
I totally feel you.
Sounds like you've both been through hard times.
The wounds women leave on a man's heart take longer to heal than a cut delivered by a sword.
It's that bad?
Beware a maiden's tears, boy, and guard yourself well. That's my advice to you.
Beware tears and guard myself.
Don't put any weird ideas into Lafayette's head, you two.
They're just facts.
If you fill his head with any more garbage, I'm eating both of you.
Yes, ma'am. Yikes.
The swordsman and the pirate having troubles with women? Ha! Well, women are nothing if not difficult. I've the deepest sympathy for you both.
What do you think of the ladies' reactions?
Well, Velvet won't eat either of you, and Magilu didn't seem sympathetic at all.
See? Appearances can be deceiving.
And it seems you've absorbed the lesson well.
Right.
I'm not like that, though. Huh? Yes. Some women use their tears to manipulate others, but not all do, and I, for one, despise such duplicity. The women who did that to Aizen and Rokuro are just the extreme.
Yeah, I can see how much you hate dishonesty, Eleanor.
Huh? Yeah, that's right.
Be a good example for the boy, then, so he doesn't end up like Rokuro and me.
I intend to do just that, whether or not you ask it of me.
Eleanor is a lot stronger than she appears.
It's like, all right, chat, we're talking about girls now. Yay.
Let us be going. At your command, I'm ready.
She's on semi-auto. Let's see what kind of arts this lady has. That's Lafayette. Thank you. Ice Edge does poison? Wow. She has nothing but martial arts on. Oh wait, equipment, mana lance, the simple ribbon. I still want that EX monster though. That's like my primary goal. Like, I want to kill that thing, and I don't even know what it is yet. She learned a Mystic Art just like that.
Effective up close.
And training can help it get even closer. Mine gets as long as I want it to be.
Thank you.
Expedition has returned. I hit strategy. Whoops.
Take a look at this.
No.
Scout ship set.
She's so pretty.
Well, Luffy said, I didn't know you were an older girls, huh? Older girls? Nah, don't worry about that. Unyielding, overturns defeats in battle. Ah, nice. Trying to see. Now I'll wait.
Huh? This stone, it's
just a rock. Take it if you want.
I think it's really rare. The way it sparkles, I think it might even be bright steel.
Bright steel? Never heard of it.
Yeah, it's actually a rare metal used to forge weapons and stuff. You don't find it just anywhere.
If there's bright steel here, that means we must be in either Endgand or Islegand. Both are a long ways off from Midgand. I doubt the Abbey has many people stationed out here.
That's our pirate! Arr! Here there be treasures shiny and sentries few!
At the very least, this could mean we'll be left alone for a while. Nice find, Luffy said.
Thanks!
Now wash your hands.
Okay.
Now wash your hands.
The only way to learn where we are is to find someone to ask, I guess. What's eating you, Luffy said?
If people say you can't judge women at face value, does that mean you can with men?
Sure. Men are simple creatures.
Men are simple. Oh! You talk like you're an expert in all things masculine. But you can only speak for your own family.
As if you're one to judge.
And I'm sure you've charmed a magnificent lord to be your lover.
Sure.
What does he look like? Is he tall?
None of your business.
Don't tell me. He was always on the other side of a swinging door, so you only saw his feet? I see. What a lovely crush that must be.
I read that story. It was a book called The Legs of a Man.
Oh? I've never heard of it.
I've read it too. It's a sad, bittersweet tale. But I enjoyed it quite a lot. I highly recommend it if you haven't read it.
Maybe when I have some free time after killing Artorias.
I just wanted to know if men could be judged at face value.
Yeah, men can. Not those snakes.
It's not often you find bright steel above ground. I hear it's a lot of trouble to unearth, even in the regions it's normally found.
Yeah. Mining for minerals takes a lot of specialized techniques and experience on the part of the prospector. They examine the soil, the water, the plants, and so on, where the same mineral was found before, then search similar environments for the next big find.
Sure, but it's not like they succeed every time. It's all a big gamble. Isn't there a simpler way?
I read in a book once that you can use a pendulum to find water and metals underground.
It's called dowsing.
What's dowsing?
You hang the pendulum so it's facing the ground. Then you chant the magic word, Magic Sam, and wait to be amazed! The little bit of ore on its tip will sniff out buried treasure and underground lakes like a bloodhound on a prickle boar!
You don't seriously believe this.
It's just like fortune telling. You win some, you lose some. That's why they call it prospecting.
So, if pendulums are used for fortune telling, why the hell is Zavid running around using them as weapons?
He uses wind to control its trajectory. I think it's easier for him to manipulate pendulums in a fight than something like a whip or a rope.
Oh, that makes sense now. That seems pretty clever.
He's probably also doing it to make himself stronger, too. Malakim broadly fall into four elemental types: earth, water, wind, and fire. Each strong or weak against the others. Wind beats earth. Zavid is a wind Malak, so when he obtains earth element minerals, his own strength is boosted.
I never realized Malakim could be so calculating.
Then if pendulums react to a Malak's powers, maybe they can actually do this dowsing stuff like Magilu says.
Yeah, it's worth taking that thing seriously. Zavid might like to joke around, but when it comes to fighting, he knows full well just what he's doing.
He puts an awful lot of thought into that weapon of his, if you ask me.
You don't?
I spare all my thoughts for my sweetheart.
Yeah, right. You just like to cause trouble without putting much thought into anything.
I am coming for that EX monster, though.
Guess it's time to fight!
Yeah.
This fight is over.
Rokuro with that level up. These all start with that. Okay. Oh. All right, we in there. Don't think you can escape me that easily. Oh, it's not even showing up yet. I want to at least get a preview of it.
You there? Got a moment?
Gah! Are you guys with the Swordbreaker?
We don't know what that is.
Get away from
okay,
me.
He's scared. You scared shitless, boys. Time to make him suffer.
I'm sorry, all right?
Real class act. Attacking as you apologize.
He's just a person.
Seven?
Mighty demon, I beg you! I'll do anything, just spare me!
I only wanted to ask you something.
You don't have to worry. This woman here is an exorcist.
Why would you say that out loud?
Huh? Right. I'm Eleanor, a praetor exorcist. Please, remain calm and hear our questions.
You do look like an exorcist, but what are you doing with ruffians like these?
Top secret Abbey business. That's all I can say. Now, can you tell us where we are? And are there any ports nearby?
You don't know? You're on Cadnix Island, an isle gate. The port is at the other end of that ravine.
I'll send a sylph jade to the Von Altia.
Thanks.
One more question. Who's this Swordbreaker?
Ah, he's a demon. Causes lots of trouble around these parts. He only attacks sword fighters, and he breaks their blades. He's even taken down a number of praetors.
Hence the name Swordbreaker.
He wields a fine sword, clearly forged in a foreign land. I tried to find his lair to steal the weapon for myself, but that's when I was attacked.
A foreign sword?
I'd be careful if I were you. If he spots that sword on your back, you'll be in a world of trouble.
Sounds like a real nasty fellow.
Well, he tries to pull anything on this demon, and he's in for one munchy crunchy surprise.
You folks are all crazy.
Either way, I'd say this is a blessing in disguise for you. You're lucky to still be alive. Take this chance to abandon your life of crime.
Burdening glacite. Slow related skills. Nice.
Let's find that port and meet up with our ship.
Can you read any of this old writing? No. I've studied many languages, but I've never seen script like this before. Can you read it, Eleanor?
I've never come across this language either. Where did you find a rare tome like this?
Well...
It was a lucky find at the capital. What can I say? The kid loves to read.
I was surprised to see how many Malakim like to read.
Kenfu does a lot of reading too.
I didn't know that.
It's true. I'm not sure what he's been reading though.
Did someone call for me?
Bienfu, do you like to read too?
Oh, yes! Books are a treasure trove of knowledge! But I'm a greater Malakim, so the literature I enjoy might be a bit above your level, Lafayette.
How to talk a human female into becoming your vessel, and physically escalating with cuties.
Bien?
Physically escalating.
Whoa.
What does that mean?
You don't really need to know.
All right.
Yeah. I'm confiscating all of these.
And I have some questions. Bienfu, you better be ready for a thorough interrogation. Bien! You look like you're having fun, Rokuro.
I'm a yaksha.
A yaksha? A spirit of war?
Yeah, a demon that lives for combat.
But this Swordbreaker has cut down exorcists with its foreign blade. Aren't you scared?
Of dying, you mean?
Yeah.
I'm not afraid of dying. It's more that I'm afraid of not being alive.
Huh?
Fighting is my life. It's all I want to do. So I fight. That's what living means to me.
Living only to kill. A demon is always going to be a demon.
Well, if you're gonna be blunt.
Oh, hello.
On to battle.
I had no problems here. Right, I'm in.
Oh, it's that. That's the EX monster right there, ladies and germs.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
I finished. This should be all right.
Let's go, asshole. Why are you running away? Don't you be scared of me.
A foe worth killing.
Level 21. Alright, man. This music hasn't changed 1 minute. Oh wow, I missed. How ironic, I just put on something that gets rid of fatigue. Clairvoyance Ventatite. Nice. There's 4 unopened chests here. Thank you. These are really good. Nice. All right. I think I'm about ready to get myself on out there again. Though I'm gonna take out Lafayette for Eleanor.
I'll follow your orders.
Even though we all know she's trying to finesse us in the end. It's okay, we'll forgive her. Come on then. Hello. Let's get a nice little save here. We're about 14 hours in, hooray. Level 20.
What's wrong?
Hi.
An enemy.
That sword. Is that Stormquell?
A demon wielding a foreign-made sword. You must be the sword.
I like how he says no words. He's just like, bitch, let's go. Let's fucking do this. But he's weak to water. Water snakes, sorry, dude. First try, boys. First try.
He's still moving.
I'll take this one. Come and get me!
Do you know that demon?
No, but I know his sword. A blade called Stormquell.
Stormquell?
Whatever. It doesn't have anything to do with us. Let's just get to the portal already.
Hey, look at that. They actually gave us experience for this one. Whoa, shit, where everybody come? Where, whoa.
Lafayette, I'm sorry about what happened back there.
I thought he was going to kill you.
Yeah, I know. You were just doing what you thought was right.
Yeah, maybe so.
That's good then. I didn't give you a clear enough warning to stay out of it. If it ever happens again, I'll give you a proper warning.
You really don't want me to help you? Even if your life is at risk?
Yep.
Why?
Actually, I'm not too sure myself.
Huh?
There's somebody out there I need to defeat by my own hand. I want to strike him down. I want to triumph against him. But to do that, I need to be a better swordsman.
Someone you have to defeat?
In a sword fight, yeah. But I'll do anything to ensure I come out on top in the end. No matter how much it costs me. Life, limb, hell, even my heart and soul, I'll pay it. Those feelings have been so central to me for so long. I lost my dang humanity somewhere along the way.
Why do you need to win that badly?
To be honest, it beats me. Maybe it has to do with me being a demon. Or maybe that's why I became one. Either way, it's more important to me than life itself.
more important than life.
But still, I owe you for saving me back there. There's no victory pose in store for me if I'm dead.
Okay. Is that how you thank someone for saving your life?
Huh? I'm just being honest with the little guy. And no offense and all, but why do you care?
You don't even think it disrespectful? You truly are a demon.
Yep. Big old demon.
So, like, congratulations, sweetheart. You hit it right on the head. Us form four cyclone dart. Hooray. Hey, hold on, I'll fight y'all in a second, alright? Let me just hit this thing first. God damn it, me. 14-hour mark, here we come. Boom. 14 hours, 5 minutes so far.
Now why does that name sound so familiar? Hey, Eleanor? Thanks for stepping in earlier.
Think nothing of it. My orders are to protect you, so I did.
Oh, I see.
Of course, orders or no orders, I'd save anyone under threat from a demon.
Well, how noble.
Oh, I got it!
Got what?
The tragic tale of the sword Stormquell! Gather round and listen, oh grimy travelers! Once, centuries past, there was a sword renowned the world over for its peerlessly sharp edge. Its forger shrouded in mystery. So mighty was each swing of the sword, it produced howling winds that could level mountains. No other sword could match its power. The people, in their superstition, began to call it the Godblade.
This Godblade, is it Stormquell?
Shush! The tale is merely beginning. Now, there was one man who was truly enamored with the Godblade. His name was Kudogane, a blacksmith of wondrous talent. His heart was set on forging an even greater sword, and he had a name in mind for this sword. Stormquell, the sword to conquer the Godblade's roaring winds.
And did he make it?
Kudogane forged scores of challengers to the Godblade, but each would-be Stormquell was shattered by the implacable howling wind. Some say the wielder of the Godblade chopped off his head. Others say he took his own life. The truth is lost to the dusty cobwebs of history. But perhaps he, and his grudge towards the Godblade, somehow yet live.
A grudge that spans centuries.
You hear tall tales like this all the time. That sword and its inscription we saw were probably just inspired by the legend.
Perhaps. But if that's the real Stormquell, we should all sleep with one eye open tonight.
What makes you say that?
Because that Godblade Kudogane wanted so desperately to top has been passed down through my family for generations. Its name is Stormhowl.
In other words, we could well bump into your armored friend again. Let's hurry it up.
Like, let's move, people. Let's move. Oh shit! Oh, dangerous encounter. Let's do it. Hell yeah. Ow. He punched the shit out of me. Just look at that. Oh, she mastered a simple ribbon. Though we gotta get her some more stuff. That demon was standing like he was in a Thriller video.
Listen, Lafayette.
What is it?
You can't trust her just because she said she'd protect you. Orders or no orders. Remember, Malakim are just tools to exorcists.
But she really did protect me.
I know you feel you owe her for that. But do you have to look so happy about it?
Sorry.
I'm not asking for an apology. I just want her to know that we've all got an eye on her. No matter how close you two get, I want her to understand that I come first.
So, what do you want me to do?
Let's see. To put it simply, I'm number one, and Eleanor is number two. Got it?
I get it. You're number one, and Eleanor is number two.
Right. I'm number one. Wait, this is kind of stupid, isn't it?
It's all right. I understand.
That's not what I mean.
So yes, I'm number one. Yes. Oh shit, another EX monster. Yo, let's get it. Oh, I'm gonna have to take a roundabout way to get to him. Yeah, that's right. Run away. I want nothing to do with you. I wonder what level this thing is gonna be, because I have not grinded levels at all. It seems like it's some type of snake demon.
A candle? What's that doing here?
Oh, I think these were used to keep robbers away. Like wards around old king's tombs. I've read about this. There's a trick to the stone. It reacts to heat.
Heat, huh? Then there's only one thing to do.
I'm over here finding out about stuff before I mess it up, so the game can explain it to me. Nothing for me over here. That thing's a monster. Hey, what's this? Gold. So is this the way to get to the secret area to fight this EX monster? It is. He looks like he does poison damage. So let's cook and eat some food. Of course, this is all just me assuming stuff. So, you know, there's that.
Are we ready for this?
Level 25. Say, fam, anytime you want to stop picking at my face, I'd appreciate it. God, I'm dying. Over. Gaussman type. Doubles the effect rate for the first strike in battle. We killed the EX monster, boys. Chalk up another W for us. Then there's the actual money and stuff. Excuse me. There's the actual money and stuff that I got for the actual boss fight. Then if I ever go back to one of those bases and talk to one of the people, they're just like, yeah, that's right. Thank you for killing that thing for us. Then I'm going to get even more money from that. Whoa, they cashed it? Lou got a level. Hooray. Out of here we go. Oh, look, it's another turtle. I'm guessing it's a turtle. Look at all these monsters. They think they can fool me. What's over here? Some souls. Hey, I'm almost at 200 souls. He's gonna see us and be like, oh god, not again. Not you guys. So was that information free too? I'm like, yeah, that's right. You bum. Seems like the slow wards are really good. They benefit everyone really well. And boots not so much. That was something I was meaning to buy for specifically for Lafayette. And I forgot what that item was. Oh, it was the Floric Bag. There we go. Put this flame ward on her. Nope, got her break soul power. Thank you.
Oh. Oh, look at that, I finally cleaned up my inventory some. Oh, I can buy peach gels now. For her. To just because cleaned up, now I'm good to go again.
No.
Well, if you aren't the craziest demon, your body's harder than your own sword.
Who's this?
That's Lord Shigure, one of the only two legate exorcists in the entire abbey.
A legate? Same as Melchior.
Eleanor! Fancy meeting you here. What the hell happened to you? You get captured by a demon? Or are you a turncoat?
I'm...
don't matter. I do my own thing. I got no standing to tell you how to live. Still, today's my lucky day. Never thought I'd encounter the one and only Stormquell.
Shigure, I think someone over there wants your attention. He looks lonely.
You're right, I'm being a jerk. Just can't pass up the chance to tease my little brother. Can I, Rokuro?
Your brother?
You haven't changed a bit, Shigure.
You go blind, dumbass? I'm bucket load stronger now. You're the one who hasn't changed, I bet. You still hung up on trying to take me down?
The one you want to beat in a fight? That's him?
I'm not who I was that day either, brother.
He is possessed.
Oh, wait. You're a demon? Now it's getting good. But I wonder, has that really changed anything? When my real storm howl breaks your sad reject again, you gonna piss yourself like last time?
I'll handle him. Lafayette, no. matter what, I need you to stay out of it.
All right.
It's been too long since we crossed swords, brother.
Shut up! You're dead! You regret sparing...
I never used Rokuro.
You're feisty as a demon. I like it. But alas, I think our fight's over.
Rokuro! What? My body!
I said stay out of this! We're just getting started!
No backing down for you this time, huh? But we're done for today.
Sigurai!
Oh, calm down, Rokuro. We could have a real fight sometime if you actually brought a decent sword. Go ask that old bastard there to make you one. I'll be waiting.
Huh? Who?
That demon in the armor, Kuragane.
The blacksmith from the story.
I'll be waiting for you at Port Cadnix. Unless you can beat me, you ain't getting off this island.
Who are you to decide that?
You got a problem with it, lady? Best of luck, you demons. You'll need it.
Lord Shigure, sir! I'm on a high-level mission!
Eleanor, babe, I get it. You've gone rogue. Have fun with that. I see you again. I'll kill you.
He wasn't even trying yet. You can tell.
But if we all fight him together...
That won't work. But there is another way.
Why is his hand so huge?
What are you talking about? What way?
Follow me.
Rokuro! Velvet, aren't we going after him?
This is his fight. It has nothing to do with me.
But Shigure said he'd be waiting at the port.
He may be a nutball, but I don't think he's fool enough to let us slip past.
Exactly. And as a swordsman, he's even more skilled than Artorias, and that's saying something.
We're mice with our tails pinned, and the cat's licking his lips.
At the very least, Kuragane seems to have some kind of plan.
Fine. We'll hear what he has to say. What was that fat cat creature with Shigure?
You mean Morgrim? She's a Moloch. She just looks different.
And?
And what? She has all the abilities of a Moloch. I'm not trying to keep anything from you. All I know is her name and that she's a Moloch.
Huh.
Lord Shigure is an exorcist legate, but he's also a warrior who can match exorcists or demons even without the use of Moloch arts. Since no one has ever seen Shigure use an art, Morgrim is considered one of the Seven Wonders of the Abbey.
The Seven Wonders of the Abbey!
No one knows Morgrim's capabilities, or even the details of Shigure's pact with her.
No one! Except me, that is!
Huh?
This is all highly classified, but Morgrim is incredibly lazy. The price she demanded of Shigure for making a pact with her was grooming and defleeing!
Anything else?
Oh, and on a point of sensitivity, she's chubby, not fat. She may be our enemy, but she's also a woman. You should try not to hurt each other's feelings.
Anything else?
Her thick eyebrows are all the rage with Malakim, so much so that false eyebrows are expected to be the next big thing.
Well, if he's that strong without Malak arts, I don't want to see what he's like with them.
Kill the cat. That's the only plan. It's the only way. But we gotta go around this corner. Hey, 200 souls. Was this not the way? We're supposed to warp through here? I don't think so. Okay, we can't go anywhere else, so we gotta go back through here. Now I'm lost. Now I don't know where I am. I wonder if I could just, like, avoid these guys. Oh, wait, I still got the holy bottle still on. Okay, never mind then.
What were you thinking, Eleanor? Attacking a legate like that?
I just thought Rokuro was going to die if I didn't intervene.
Oh? You'd kill one of your own allies for a demon?
I acted without thinking. Sometimes I'm too soft-hearted to a fault.
I'd say it's less that, and more just stupidity. You're supposed to be protecting Lafayette. Don't get yourself into trouble you don't need.
Even if one of her own is in danger?
Even then.
This kid must be really important to her. All right. I understand.
Lafayette, next time she acts up, stop her. Understand? We don't know what she's got up her sleeve.
Okay. Thanks for not telling on me, Eleanor. And I'm sorry I hijacked your body.
I understand how it feels to want to protect your friends. The problem's with those demons, not you.
But I think Velvet has the capacity to feel the same way, too. At least when it comes to her brother.
Is that why you're staying with her?
I'm not sure. It's hard to say.
I have to figure out what's going on with this group. If I ever hope to wrest the child from them.
Nope. What is this thing? Oh, it's a... I wasn't sure if there was a monster or not. So I just kind of activated the fight by accident. Seems to win, which is weird. You would have thought these things would be exclusively with the fire, being in an ice cave and all. He wants me. Too bad he can't have me. Alright, so what the hell is this? I guess this is just like a bonus area or something. I think I inadvertently went the right way. Because there's this thing here. There's that entire void that's sitting there waiting on us. I do seriously think I like went the wrong way. Nope, no I didn't. Alright. The doubts have been cleared.
That's what happens when the legendary blacksmith Kurogane toils so hard he forgets to die.
I gave up everything, thinking of nothing else but forging a sword that could surpass Storm Howl. And before I knew it,
you had traded your humanity for demonhood.
I see I'm not the only one. So great was your grudge against your brother, the inheritor of Storm Howl.
Well, guess we're not so different. You don't suppose you could hammer me up a new sword, do you?
I've forged countless blades over these long years, yet not one has proven a match for Storm Howl. And yet you still seek a Kurogane sword?
I'll put it like this. No matter how much you've failed across the centuries, you've never broken. Well, I'm the same way. If anything can break Shigure and his god blade, it's the bitterness I carry.
Strangely enough, seeing you and your brother has given me an idea that might work. I will forge you a new blade.
Should we get some Brightstone?
Nope. No need for that.
Huh?
Should I take it from the top?
If you would. My arms are all I'll be needing.
What are you doing?
Don't be alarmed. I'm just cutting free some raw materials for the sword.
You see something new every day.
You need his head to make the sword?
That's right. With this fine clump of pure resentment, I shall forge your imitation Storm Howl anew.
No. I only keep this imitation as a reminder of how weak-willed I was in the past. To defeat Shigure, I've perfected the art of dual-wielding, a secret Rangetsu technique.
All right. If that's what you prefer, a pair of short swords it is.
And here I thought he would have got like a new sword and start like using a katana or something like that. I think that would have been cool.
I made the Enfu rush out to the docks to scout the place out. Pretty smart, am I right?
I pity that creature sometimes.
That Kurogane, though, what a character! Giving his own body to forge a sword, like some kind of ritual sacrifice.
Ritual sacrifice? It's certainly something only a demon would do. It was a necessary sacrifice in order to gain power.
A necessary sacrifice? What a vicious turn of phrase.
Indeed.
Still, I can't say I'm not thrilled to see how it all turns out. If what you give is mere meat for a god's morbid lunch, could there be a more trivial sacrifice? But if the offering is one's own body and soul, even a single hair can be portentous. I wonder which he will have been in the end.
The ship is on its way, right on schedule.
Of course it is. They don't have the Reaper on board.
One more thing. Apparently, Shigure is Artorias's bodyguard.
So we'll have to face him down sometime, no matter what.
It's in our best interest to get rid of him while he's working alone. The problem is, Rokuro can't beat him by himself.
Agreed. Shigure is not to be trifled with.
Certainly. That's why, when Rokuro creates an opening, we're going to take Shigure out.
You want us to meddle in somebody else's private quarrel?
If it affects my own quarrel, yes.
I suppose I'm in the same position. Besides, I can still use him. There's no sense in throwing his life away.
Rokuro's not really a guy to care about the big picture. He might try to hack your limbs off a bit, but he'll get over it.
Rokuro, Kurogane, I just do not understand them. You saw them. Demons. We're crazy.
Sure. But they go through life with such crystal clear sense of purpose.
Even demons have things they're not willing to let go. Or do you think us mere animals, running around killing people left and right?
I know. I understand demons still have a certain consciousness, but I look at those two and they seem passionate, like normal people.
Well, I've yet to meet a human so passionate he'd chop his own head off.
Do you have a purpose like they do?
I do, in fact. Ever since Artorias used my brother as a sacrifice.
Typical demon nonsense. The Abbey exists to protect the people. Yes, sometimes cold, painful decisions need to be made to protect the many. But they'd never stoop to human sacrifice. Besides, as shepherd, Artorias will cleanse the world of...
If that's what you think, ask the precious shepherd yourself. Ask him just what he did 3 years ago.
He wouldn't. He'd never...
Rokuro wants to slay his brother, even if it kills him. And Kurogane had his own head lopped off just to forge powerful swords. How do those two find it in themselves to go so far?
It's just how they are. They're demons. Not exactly normal.
Yeah, it's scary. But I also kinda admire it. But me, I don't have anything I'm that desperate to accomplish.
Not yet, you mean. In time, you'll find something.
You really think so?
Almost certainly. But don't feel you have to go and risk your life over it. You're not a demon, and you should stay that way. You deserve a normal life.
Okay.
But never mind. Just the foolish ramblings of a demon girl.
Bad, bad news! A group of praetors have left the docks and are headed this way! They said they were coming to purge Eleanor the traitor!
Purge? Velvet, what do we do?
We take them head on. And you're fighting with us, Eleanor.
An order, I presume.
It is. Protect Lafayette. And defeat the exorcists.
All right. I understand.
Just remember, if we lose Eleanor, Lafayette will turn into a demon.
I haven't forgotten. But we need to pool all the resources we have. She needs us for her own ends. And we'll use that to our advantage in this fight.
Just don't push your luck too far, Velvet.
And so recently was she a noble, upstanding young exorcist. How quickly one falls when entering Velvet's dark orbit.
Ask me if I care.
Fight off the exorcist invading the mine. Well, let me save first. Alright, baby. We're in there. Yeah, that's right. Get it out of the way.
Dragon's Claw. Is that a Mystic Art? No, that's not. Wonder if I can get another level. Oh, that's why I'm learning in that. Don't touch that, you'll get hurt. But the rest of her is fair game. Yo, Magilu is the best. She is the bestest. Like, yeah, man, touch them titties.
Praetor Eleanor, you should be ashamed of yourself, cowering to demons.
Your collusion could spell disaster to the Abbey if left unchecked. The only possible atonement is your death.
They're level 5? Why are they level 5?
Betrayed the people and sullied Artorias' ideals.
No, that's not. Velvet, she's testing me. I know I have to fight,
My mission calls for it. But any more of this will kill them.
Time for you to die and be purged! Eleanor!
I can't do it. I can't kill them.
I'm not done yet.
There. Now we're even, Eleanor.
You've got new swords. Sinister. I like it.
I take it you're ready.
Yeah. All that's left is to kill Shigure.
With me as a witness.
I... Keep on fighting like that, and you'll be killed. And if you get killed, Lafayette will lose his vessel.
I know that.
Velvet, wait.
You're not going to kill them? I'm just not that hungry right now. I've got new orders for you. Fight the exorcists, but make sure they don't die.
Understood.
I guess that was as far as Eleanor could go.
I think so. Push her any further and she's bound to break.
Ever the virtuous exorcist.
That very virtue is what lets her be Lafayette's vessel. Besides, I can't help but admire her commitment. She's enduring total disgrace to accomplish her mission.
How uncommonly pleasant of you.
Pleasant folks don't use people the way we do.
Yeah, you've got that right.
Hey, Bienfu? I was wondering if I could talk to you about something that's on my mind.
I figured it was just about the time that you and I had the talk, actually. I've seen it all, heard it all, and even tasted it all in my time as a monk. Ask me anything you want!
Thanks. I was hoping you could let me borrow those books you were reading earlier, if that's okay.
You mean, how to talk a human female into becoming your vessel? And how to get the cuties?
Hey! Keep it down! Keep it down!
But you and Madam Eleanor have already formed a pact! Why do you still need either of those books?
Well, it's like when we're alone together, things get so awkward. It's hard to talk with her, you know?
That happens a lot with Malachiman vessels who are still new to the whole thing. I've been there. In that case, I've got an even better book for you.
Whoa, you read a lot of books.
I'm just an avid learner is all. Now let's see. Oh, here we go. Hot Spring Topics, Bearing Your Body and Your Soul. Being upfront and honest is always the best policy.
I don't think we'll be bathing in any hot springs together. Do you have anything else?
Ever the tactician.
Right, then how about after bath party games, dropping your defenses and your towels?
Why do you keep trying to get us naked? I think that would just make things even more awkward.
Picky, picky. Tell you what, you can just look at my collection and pick whatever sounds good.
Love hacking. Wow. Living long and loving hard. Diary of a diary thief. Hands speak louder than words.
Yo!
All classics. I remember reading them when Miss Magilu and I were struggling to get along. Oh, to be young again.
You ever think maybe things would have been easier if you never read these books?
Reading the mood. Knowing what to say and how to say it. That one's a winner. A must read for sure.
Are you two reading something together?
We are. We are. Lafayette's been worried about that awkward distance between you two, and he came to me for some advice. I've heard his side of the story, so let's you and I grab some tea and talk about what to do about it. Come on. Let's go. Let's go.
Oh, okay.
Knowing what to say and how to say it. I don't think this will help either.
living long and loving hard. This holy bottle has lasted like two whole streams. I don't think that's the way. Attack increase just like that? Wow. Oh, that was all the bronze scrap. Okay. All right, fully upgraded. Fully upgraded, boys, and we're ready to go. We're gonna get past this particular section, then I'll end the stream here. There's a way that I can keep that on. Okay, so I totally went the wrong way then. I'm legit angry at myself for doing that too. Like, the whole point was for me to go through this cave, and I did exactly not that.
Take a look at this.
Booyah.
Well, well. Now here's a fine haul. Scout ship set.
Can't believe I went. I did all that just to go backwards. Oh, wait a minute. Fashion. I forgot to put the rose corsage on Eleanor here. Minnie Lloyd. And I'm gonna put a halo on her because she is a precious cinnamon roll. There. Left sweat bangs. It's already hard enough for her to see.
Why did he call your storm howl a reject?
Well, you see, when blacksmiths make swords, they don't just make one at a time. They make a whole bunch. The best one of them all is the one that gets presented to the sword's commissioner, while the rest are tossed aside.
Huh. I didn't realize the standards were so high.
The head of my clan gets the real storm howl, and his siblings get the remainders.
So one is real, and the others are imitations?
I guess so. Shigure has the real one, and yeah, I guess that makes mine an imitation.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to imply...
Don't apologize. You got me to finally realize something. It might just be why I'm so hung up on beating him.
Oh. And to Velvet, which Lafayette is real, and which is the imitation?
Oh, what are you saying?
She means my name. It's the same as Velvet's brother's.
Huh? The one who went and got sacrificed by Artorias. Surely you are mistaken. Our shepherd would never do such a thing.
But what else could make Velvet hate Artorias so much?
I don't... So you have a truth, and Velvet has a truth. Now which is the real one, and which is the imitation?
Excuse me, gentlemen, I just wish to go by. I don't wish to fight you all right now. Or at all. Ourselves a nice little fire door here. Oh no, it's on the other side of that thing. Whatever will we do? Shit, excuse me. Sorry. Hella souls. They're very intent on making us work for this. Holy crap. Hooray. So now it's just a go back.
Shigure both use the Rangetsu style, but to me it looked like you both fight completely differently. Why is that?
Our school encompasses two distinct forms. To the outside world, we're known for fighting with a single great sword, but we also study dual short swords should need arise.
So Shigure uses the great sword, and you use the short.
In most schools, wouldn't the secondary technique be used primarily in support of the first?
That's true for us as well. We learned the dual short swords to provide sparring partners for those studying the great sword.
Then why would you handicap yourself against Lord Shigure? He's no mere swordsman.
As I'm painfully aware, Shigure is a true master. We trained together since we were small children. I was his sparring partner for 10 years. His skill with the great sword is godlike. So, in order to beat him, I took up the short blades. To our school, it might be secondary, but it's what I know best.
You're badly disadvantaged in reach.
If I eliminate my fear, I have a chance. If I can control the terror of being split in half and I can step inside his guard, he'll have 2 times the trouble.
Eliminating fear, huh? The style for someone who's lost his humanity.
Right?
It's like you two brothers are the very swords you carry.
Huh?
Storm Howl, a godlike sword known to all as the strongest there ever was. Storm Quell, burdened by the ceaseless struggle to best the other. One, an exorcist who walks in the light. One, a demon moving through the shadows. The only thing these two polar opposites want
is to cut down the other.
Precisely! Both are renowned blades. But I don't see what exorcists and demons have to do with it.
You don't? Man, you get more and more basic. This is why I put the halo on you. I started from... Then... Let me try going here then. No, this is definitely the way to go, I remember now. Ah, you missed me. Save right here. Did I not? Okay, so why does Rukuro not have these on then? Don't get me wrong, that's more like it, but what the hell, man? Give me something. Damn you. Okay. I'm gonna do a quick save here. Then we'll be good to go. I'm gonna start this fight. Then it'll be the end of the stream.
Which must mean they took out every one of the exorcists who went after them.
Hey, I told them not to bother. Now how did that sword of yours turn out? Fine. I'll find out myself.
Rokuro, we can handle the exorcists. Go and find your victory.
Thanks.
All right, let's get down to business.
He's weak to fire?
You better not die too quickly on me. I want this fun. Come on, bro. Don't hold back. Shut up. Don't play games with me. Put up a good fight, I'll give you that. But you're a frickin' demon. Shouldn't you bring more to the table than pretty damn good Rangetsu style? You don't have what it takes to win against the rightful heir.
Don't count me out. Just yet. I've got something to show you! Take this! What?
Now that was clever. Giving up one of your own hands to go for my neck. If I was just a second slower, I'd be dead now. I like it. This is what I've been looking for. All right, let's call it good here. Listen up. If y'all want any hope of beating me, come find me once you're more skilled and better armed.
I'll cut you down. No matter how many times I lose, no matter how many years it takes.
There we go. That's the face I'm looking for. So vicious, it's perfect.
What is wrong with him?
Shouldn't you be worrying more about your own skin? The entire Abbey knows by now that you're a traitor.
That guy, he was really strong.
Yeah, he was. They all are.
But we will beat him if we must. No matter what it takes.
The Von Eltius here.
Let's get going.
Please, take me with you. I'll make a sword that surpasses Stormhowl yet. I know I will. But for another blade to beat Stormhowl, its wielder must be a swordsman of unmatched skill.
Hey, Aizen. Got any room on this pile of wood scrap for a suit of armor?
If not, make someone wear it.
Works for me. You heard him, Kurogane.
Many thanks.
Okay, we're off to find Grimoire and decipher the book. You know where we're going, right, kiddo?
Yeah, we're headed for the Isolde Archipelago in Southgand.
Man, everybody got hella level ups. Numbing Glacier, Paralysis, yeah.
Velvet's Demon Hand. It's such a mysterious weapon. I can only imagine how much of a threat it will become to the Abbey. This calls for a clear-headed breakdown of everything I know about it so far. It changes shape in a flash, and could devour most anything. How must that feel, to devour something with your hand like that? But it doesn't devour the bandages that cover it up. Maybe they're protected with some sort of special art? Likewise, the rest of her outfit can't be ignored. One would think she wouldn't want to wear such ragged clothing, yet she clearly has no inclination of buying something new. I suppose that could be taken to mean she has some sort of attachment to it. But that top is really big for her. Like it was made for a man! Maybe she wears that outfit in memory of someone important to her. I'd better not touch it then. I know I may not look it, but I really am good at sewing. Maybe I should suggest mending her clothes rather than outright replacing them. On the other hand, that fabric looks like it would be hard to push a needle through. I could be in over my head. But the tougher the fight, the more I get fired up! Of course, Lord Artorias would probably scold me if he heard me talking like that.
Who'd scold you for what now?
Oh, well, I was thinking about sewing. I mean, your clothes, they're all beat up, and I thought that if I offered to mend them for you, you'd probably scold me, wouldn't you? you'd mend my clothes? Have they been worrying you that much?
I mean, not like constantly or anything. It just crosses my mind from time to time.
Are you good at it?
Yes. I'm told I come across as awkward sometimes, but if nothing else, I'm good with my hands.
Wow.
I see. All right. If I ever need it done, I'll come to you.
Good. Just leave it to me.
Are you feeling all right? You're really sweating. The heat and the cold doesn't bother me at all. But you're a human, so you need to take care of yourself. And if you keep soaking in your own sweat, you'll catch a cold. Besides, I don't imagine it feels that great. You should keep washing and bathing on your own schedule, like however you did before falling in with us. Just let me know and I'll make it work. Because the guys aren't considerate enough to stop and ask you if you need to.
Sure. All right. Thanks. That was a surprisingly normal thing for her to say. I probably shouldn't bother with her clothes for now. We girls have to be considerate of each other.
So, you guys made it. Whatever happened to that sword breaker?
He's been dealt with.
What are you doing here?
After everything you said to me, I had a change of heart. I quit banditry. Thank you.
I'm glad you listened to reason. What do you plan on doing from here on out?
I'm heading to the capital. I plan on opening a restaurant for bandit cuisine.
Bandit cuisine?
Yeah. You get your hands on all sorts of food as a bandit. You gotta use what you have, and still make a tasty meal. Like a wild mushroom omelet, minus the eggs. Or highwayman's stew. It's like a hunter's stew, but, you know, made by bandits.
That sounds somewhat improper, actually. But I'd still love to visit after you open.
Really? All right. I'll be an upright citizen in no time. Maybe even the kind of man you'd consider spending some time with.
I'm rooting for you.
Hey, were you actually listening to him?
Of course I was. It's wonderful he's turned over a new leaf.
Hey, you there. What impressive swords you got.
You know a lot about swords?
I'm a novice swordsmith. Been at it for 20 years. Now, I'm finally able to make a blade worthy of the name.
20 years? And still just a novice?
It's a competitive world out there for a swordsmith. Especially here on this island.
But I heard many swordsmiths have given up. There's less ore around nowadays, and swords don't work against the demons.
True, swords are useless against demons. Unless it's an exorcist that's using them. Kednik's weaponry has always been prized in Midgant. The Abbey recognized our talents, and now, business is booming. All the smiths here are grateful to the Abbey. They're keeping all of us alive and fed.
I'm gonna talk to this last side character, then I'm gonna go to that save point. Not this one. Harbinger of Death, yeah, I killed that. And the coming tendrils. What is this? The Yivlong, the Volong ruins? Level 20? I'm gonna get something nice.
Aizen, I thought you were supposed to be in Midgand. How did you end up here in Islegand? I thought I'd gotten used to you performing the impossible, but this time, I'm at a loss for words. We heard from the Bloodwings that the Abbey might have taken you guys out.
Not this time, but our luck won't last forever. Think of this as a dry run for when I really kick the bucket.
Aye, aye, first mate. More importantly, are you sure it's okay to bring an exorcist aboard?
I've got my eye on her. If she does anything funny, I'll handle it.
Got it! We'll be on our guard, too.
Cool. That's where I'm going. And I'm already at Port Candix. But we will save that for another stream. Alright, I'd like to thank everybody for watching, lurking, doing whatever. This was Tales of Berseria, and I'm your lovely host, Edward, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out.